This is the Folio manuscript from 1642 CE, depicting the Armenian liturgical calendar. However, it's not just a page from a manuscript. Hi, I'm Dr. Smiti Nathan, and I'm an archaeologist. In this video, we're going to explore this artifact and how it gives us a glimpse of 4 millennia of astronomical knowledge and Armenian cultural history. This region has a deep history of astronomical observation. From their rock art, figurines, and maps, archaeologists and historians have learned just how much ancient Armenians understood about the cosmos. Even ancient Armenian writing contained elements of celestial symbolism. Some of these ideas were preserved over time in later documents, including calendars. In fact, celestial bodies have influenced many ancient calendars. Let's first examine the ancient Armenian calendar. The formation of the Armenian calendar in 2341 BCE has often been attributed to Haik Nahapet, who is often viewed as the legendary founder of Armenia. Haik is often associated with characteristics of a creator god, as well as a thunder god and war god. Haik's origin story is often intertwined with the biblical figure Bel, also known as Nimrod, whom he slays with his arrow. Haik is still a central figure in modern Armenian nationality and ideas of ancestry. The Armenian calendar appears to have symbolic associations with the Orion constellation, which was known in Armenian tradition as the Haik constellation. The beginning of the Armenian Haykian calendar changed year to year, but the major holiday Navisard was fixed. It was observed when the Betelgeuse star of the Haik constellation rose in the sky, known as the helical rising of this star. This calendar was composed of 360 days, divided into 12 months of 30 days each. 5 additional days, known as Avalek, were tacked onto each year. 301 CE is often marked as the time when Christianity entered Armenia, and their calendars changed too. Armenians in the medieval period developed 2 calendars, the Armenian Major Calendar and the Armenian Minor Calendar. The Major Calendar was formed by the order of Armenian Catholicos Moses Egevendetsi in 1552 CE. It was divided into the same number of months and days as the Haykian calendar. However, it had a movable start to the beginning of the year, Navisard 1. The minor calendar was formed in 1112 CE and now had a leap year. Often, calendars usually fall into one of 3 types: lunar, solar, and lunisolar. The medieval Armenian calendar is an example of a lunar solar calendar that arranged the liturgical calendar with natural seasonal cycles and daily, hourly, weekly, and yearly cycles. Across time, Armenian calendars relied on natural cyclical processes. For example, these could include the changing of the seasons or the passage of stars and constellations through the night sky. These natural processes inform calculations and timings of things like the passage of day, as well as dates for equinoxes and solstices. Combining natural events and religious observances reflected the synchronization of beliefs held by medieval Armenians. If we go back to the first example we showed, these folio pages date to 1642 CE and are currently held in Our Lady of Bizumar Convent in Bizumar, Lebanon. You can see the Armenian liturgical calendar depicted as a circular calendar. The calculations and movement of the sun and constellations are represented within the circular calendars. Surrounding them are 8 angelic beings. This artifact depicts the synchronization of the natural and religious worlds that we mentioned before. These folios showing the medieval Armenian calendar reflect a history of astronomical knowledge and calendar systems that stretch back to the 3rd millennium BCE. If you're interested in learning about other ancient calendars, we have a video on that linked below. This video is part of our Artifact of the Day series, where we take a quick look at one intriguing object from the past. If you're interested in watching another Artifact of the Day video, check out the video here.